Bhakta Srutadeva. Mithila was the capital of the territory of Videha. Bahulasva was its king, who was a great devotee of Sri Krishna. He was free from ego, simple and charitable. There was a Brahmin by name Srutadeva in Mithila, who was equally a great devotee of Sri Krishna. He was very poor, yet charitable. Sri Krishna wanted to bestow his grace on both of them and started for Mithila. He was accompanied by a big assembly of sages, including Devarishi Narada, Vamadeva, Atri, Vyasa, Parashurama, Aruni, Sukha, Brihaspati, Kanva, Maitreya, Chyavana, and others. Hearing of their approach, the king and Srutadeva both received them at the gates of the city, and both of them invited all of them to their humble dwellings. Sri Krishna agreed. He simultaneously visited both of them in two separate forms, unnoticed by the others, with all the sages. Bahulasva received them with devotion, washed their feet, worshipped them, gave them a good feast, and remained in their service. He requested them to remain with him for some days, and they agreed to do so. At Srutadeva's dwelling also, Sri Krishna arrived with all the sages. The Brahmin of slender resources received them with devotion, washed their feet, worshipped them, and gave them seeds of kusha grass, and offered a feast to his best capacity, and requested them to remain there for some days, to which they also agreed. Sri Krishna extolled the greatness of saints and sages to Srutadeva. Saints sanctify places by their mere visit. They purify the devotees by their mere look. They are the embodiment of the Supreme. One must see the manifestation of the Supreme in them, worship them with devotion, and by that the Supreme would have been worshipped. Similarly, he advised Bahulasva, and both of them followed his advice implicitly. Both of them attained the supreme state of bliss. Sri Krishna returned to Dwaraka. Parikshit inquired, "O sage, the declarations of all the Shrutis fall within the limits of the three gunas and their modifications. Brahman transcends the gunas, transcends cause and effect, and is indefinable. So how can the Shrutis directly indicate Brahman?" Sage Sukha quoted the answer of the divine sage Narayana to a similar question of Devarishi Narada. Sage Narayana was born to safeguard the prosperity and spiritual well-being of man by his asceticism, piety, and renunciation. He was giving the following reply in the assembly of ancient sages like Sanaka and others. Once there was a discussion about Brahman in the presence of Brahma. The discussion was about which the Vedas were silent. Sage Sanandana was expounding his sacred views. At the close of a great deluge and before the dawn of the next creation, the deities presiding over the Shrutis began to praise the Supreme. "O Lord, please wake up and remove the ignorance of the Jivas. The time for thy sport with the aid of your Yoga Maya is coming. The universe comes out from, remains in, and returns back to you, the Brahman. You are the material cause for the universe. So, whatever is comprehended by the mind is only Brahman. Sages drink the nectar of hearing your stories and get rid of their sins. They contemplate on you as the eternal consciousness and bliss. They implicitly obey your commands. Some contemplate on Brahman as presiding in the abdomen as Manipuraka. Some on the Anahata Chakra, situated in the heart. From there, the Sushumna Nadi reaches the head where the Sahasrara is situated. The Vedas describe you as the Purusha. All actions, when offered at your sacred feet, eliminate rebirth. Devotees who are addicted to drinking the nectar of your stories, do not worry about liberation. Even your enemies, by thinking of you constantly, have had the fortune of merging in you. The gopis set their mind on you and obtained liberation. The sages look on you as present everywhere and worship you. A man who, after obtaining the human body, does not think of you, simply kills his soul. The jiva, the mind, the three gunas, though unreal, are really your own manifestations. The Atmajnani sees you everywhere as gold is seen in jewels. Even the sun, moon, fire, wind, and the lord of death perform their duties because of your fear. You are ever free, but you take the association of your yoga maya. Relatives, progeny, wife, body, wealth, houses, land, chariots, etc. can give no pleasure without your grace. Sages have discarded them all and taken refuge in you. Those who are attached to these objects can never have liberation. This world is perceived on account of avidya, ignorance. This universe emerges from you, remains in you and merges in you. These appearances are unreal. It is a play. You are the real substratum. Men of self-knowledge do not get affected by the two opposites as joy and sorrow, good and bad. They have no karma or karma phala. The saints find their goal in you by negating everything other than you. Having heard this long discourse, Sanaka and others paid their respects to Sanandana for the brilliant exposition. Thus, the ancient sages were able to churn out knowledge of Vedas and come to a decision about Brahman. This is the essence of the Vedas, Samhitas and Upanishads. By hearing this, all the desires of man are burnt up. Having heard all these reverently, sage Narada proclaimed, "Hail to the celebrated Lord Sri Krishna, who assumes all forms in order to put an end to the births of souls." Narada took leave of sage Narayana, reached Vyasa and narrated to him the whole discourse. O Parikshit, Brahman can thus be penetrated and reached by the mind even though he is beyond the three gunas. By constantly remembering Srihari, all fears are dispelled and Maya is kept at a distance.